Earlier this month, the cities of Ishpeming and Negaunee went head-to-head for their inaugural Fight to Fill the Blood Bank competition to help encourage the community to donate blood to the UP Regional Blood Center. And the numbers are in. Local 3's Brandon McLean stopped by Negaunee High School earlier today, where the winner received their trophy.
A friendly competition between Ishpeming and Negaunee resulted in saving lives right here in the Upper Peninsula. Ishpeming drew 24 pints of blood and Negaunee drew 53, totaling 77 pints. Each pint of blood represents a saving capacity of 3 lives, or a total of 231 lives saved due to this event.
We definitely don't really care about a trophy. We don't care really about the win. It was about the idea of raising awareness and then getting folks to come out and donate blood to our area. With this shortage that we know of, and the shortage that always is out there, who's going to donate that blood? And the question is, we're the only ones that can.
Negaunee High School's National Honor Society helped bring Negaunee to victory.
Alyssa and I were tasked with leading the blood drive and just organizing it throughout the school and community to raise support to get as much blood as we could to beat Ishpeming.
Both city managers of Ishpeming and Negaunee have pledged to hold this event annually. And although Negaunee technically won the battle, Ishpeming City Manager Craig Cugini says the community really won.
I think Nate and I will have to sit down and talk and kind of generate a little bit of a framework. We'll probably invite other communities to participate as well, because it's all about the county, it's about the UP, it's a regional event. And while Nate and I kind of sparked this to start, I'm sure it should be able to grow.
The UP Regional Blood Center is currently experiencing a critical need for O positive, A negative, O negative, and B negative blood types. To learn more on how to donate blood, you can visit mgh.org/blood. Reporting from Negaunee, Brianna McLean, Local 3 News.